This video walks you through how to set up plotting in C++ on a Windows machine. Now, it is June 2021 as I'm filming this, so if you're watching this in the future, things might have changed. So keep that in mind. But as of now, this should work on most Windows setups. So what are you going to need for this? Well, you will need Git, Visual Studio, Gnuplot, Gnuplot IO Stream, and Vcpkg. Now, I'm not going to go over installing Git and Visual Studio. There's plenty of material out there. But the rest of the steps we are going to cover. So let's get started. Okay, so let's go to the homepage of Gnuplot, which is at gnuplot.info, and just download the binary. It's on SourceForge. I'm just going to grab it from here, the latest version. And I'm going to run this binary. Okay, next. Now this is going to take a while. We are going to get Vcpkg and install boost. Okay, so we will copy this. So the link is at github.com/Microsoft/Vcpkg. If you're doing C++ development, this is good to have anyways. This is what we're going to use. All right, enter that. And I have my Vcpkg set up in, what is going on here? My computer seems frozen. Okay. Computer was frozen for a second, but okay. So we're going to enter this directory and run the bootstrap file. All right, that's done. And now what you want to do is you want to run the following. Vcpkg install boost x64 Windows and boost x86 Windows. So you'll be able to compile both 32 and 64-bit projects in Visual Studio. And this will take a while. This is going to take, on my machine, it's a virtual machine, it's probably going to take probably 45 minutes. So go do something else and come back and it should be done.
A few moments later.
Okay, so that took a while, but it's done. Before we can move on, we have to type in one command, which is vcpkg integrate install. And what this will do is it'll make, Visual Studio know where it can find these libraries. Okay, so let's start up. I think we can start up the Visual Studio project now. Let's create a new C++ project. Now we need this. Okay, so this is at github.com/gnuplot-iostream. And what we need here is this header file. Okay. I'll just copy this. And let's create header file. That's fine. We can add it right there for now. Let's import the header file. Now, as of filming this, this header file works best with C++ 17. So we're going to right click on the project, go to properties, make sure that all the configurations and all platforms are pointing to C++ 17. Apply that. Okay, so a couple of quick things here. The dashes that you see right there, what that is telling Gnuplot is to listen on standard in. So we have in that command, we have two dashes. And that means that, hey, Gnuplot, we are going to send you data via standard in. The other thing to keep in mind is that right before that semicolon, when a gnuplot command ends, you have to give it that newline character. Without the newline character, it's going to error out. The third thing to keep in mind, and this is a Windows-specific thing, is that you have to give the instance, when you're declaring that GP object there, you have to give it the exact path to the gnuplot binary. It works without this on Linux, but on Windows, I've noticed that you need to be explicit. And there's a very specific way to type that in. So do that exactly as I'm doing that here. And let's try to compile this. I'm just going to do x64 release. Okay, so you'll get this warning about stir error. This is easy to fix. Just do char. That should compile and run. And finally, if you found this video helpful, you can help me out by giving it a thumbs up. Also, if there is interest in another Gnuplot video that goes through plotting examples, leave a comment below and I could maybe cook something up. Thanks for watching.